Hi, I'm Michael Kelley. I'm an astronomer at the University of Maryland, and I study comets, and I'm interested in finding out what they can tell us about the early solar system. A main belt comet is an object that is not quite an asteroid, but also not quite a comet. It looks like an asteroid because it lives in the asteroid belt with all the other, most of the other asteroids in our solar system. However, it has the appearance of a comet. It has a tail, it has a coma, and behaves otherwise like a comet. Yet its origin is not similar to the other comets in our solar system. We looked at all the main belt comets and we identified the best one that could be studied for its activity, and that was comet 238P Reid. The instrument we decided to use was the near-spec instrument on the James Webb Space Telescope. And it has the spectral capabilities that are perfect for studying the main volatiles in comets. So what we saw was a bright water gas band. It is actually the first detection of any gas at a main belt comet. More typical comets have water, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and other molecules in their comae. However, these main belt comets are so faint, it took the capabilities of the James Webb Space Telescope in order to detect it. This discovery kind of unlocks a hidden reservoir of water ice in the main asteroid belt. It shows us that water ice can survive for long timescales in the main asteroid belt and gives us a sample of material that we wouldn't otherwise get. Asteroids sometimes produce meteors, and those meteors sometimes produce meteorites, and we can study the composition of asteroids through meteorites. However, water ice would never survive to the surface of the Earth, and so this is a unique way to study asteroids.